Hey church, it's me, Chip Kendall, repping for South location today, coming to you from Stockport. Hey, I have just finished one of our early morning prayer Zooms. If you have not joined in with one of our Audacious prayer team's early morning 7:30 a.m. Zoom calls, you are missing out. I want to highly encourage you guys to check that out. But today's devotion comes from Romans chapter 12, verses 9 to 13, and the NIV. It says this, it says, love must be sincere. Hate what is evil, cling to what is good, be devoted to one another in brotherly love, honor one another above yourselves, never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with God's people who are in need and practice hospitality. And that's the version that I memorize it in, but I'm going to read it to you today from the New Living Translation, and this is so hot. Romans 12, 9 to 13. Don't just pretend to love others. Really love them. Hate what is wrong. Hold tight to what is good. Love each other with genuine affection, and take delight in honoring each other. Never be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. Rejoice in our confident hope. Be patient in trouble and keep on praying. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. In my written version of this devotion, I talk a little bit about how incredible it is that God's word has stood the test of time. I mean, these are ancient truths. Sometimes we forget they're written like thousands of years ago, and yet there's so many little lines and nuggets and moments of wisdom that are like tweetable still today. And I just think it's important that we do make our home in the word of God. It's a little bit like the best advice you could possibly be given. In my written devotion, I liken it to kind of being out fishing with like your grandfather, or maybe sitting down to a nice warm cup of coffee with a close friend that you can confide in. And I just think that that's so important that we make the Bible our home. Each and every day, God puts on a new spread, a new table laid with the most incredible things that we need during our day. You know, if you've ever smelled freshly cooked bread, you know what I'm talking about. It's like even just the aroma of it is enough to get you going, and you can't wait to eat that bread. Guys, it's the same with the Bible. It's living bread. It's a living word. And his table is spread with grace. His table is spread with hope. His table is spread with his presence, which the Bible says gives us joy that can be our strength. That's our fuel to get us through the day. And I just want to encourage you to come around God's word, to come to God's word. Make it a priority. Why? Well, the same way you make breakfast, lunch, and dinner a priority, because you need it. You need it to fuel your lives. And you can take even just any one of those little lines from that Bible verse, you know, share with God's people who are in need. Or you can talk about praying, be faithful in prayer. Or you could talk about being enthusiastic. I mean, we've heard Pastor Glenn go on and on, haven't we, about enthusiasm, en theos, in God. If you want to have enthusiasm, you need to be in God. The more that we are in God, the more enthusiastic we are. And all of this starts from God's word. So maybe just take two or three of those little nuggets of wisdom and let them apply to your own life. Have a little moment just to meditate and to stop and to think about that. In fact, I don't think we tend to do this very much in these little quick devotions, but I want to create some space right now. I'm not actually going to say anything. I'm going to wait on God. You're going to let the video play. If you hang up too early, you're lost. But I hope that you will just take this moment right now with your screen on. You don't even have to put it on mute. I'm just going to be quiet because I want God to allow his word to sink in for you right now. Let's take this moment. Lord, I pray for each and every person watching this right now. I pray that your love in them would be sincere today, that they would hate what is evil, that they would cling to what is good, that they'd be devoted to one another in brotherly love, honoring each other above themselves, never lacking in zeal, but keeping that spiritual fervor, serving the Lord, that they'll be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, and faithful in prayer, that they would learn to share with God's people who are in need and to practice hospitality. Lord, I pray that your word would live for us today, that it would give us life, that it would be fuel that inspires, encourages us, and gives us enthusiasm to do your work. Thank you, Lord, that really work is just worship unto you. Everything we do today, I pray that we do it unto you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. God bless, guys.